Welcome again in History Civics class, and today we are going to start chapter 5, the Khalji Dynasty. The Khalji Dynasty was the second dynasty of Delhi Sultanate. And today's topic are the foundation of the Khalji Dynasty, Jalaluddin Khalji and Alauddin Khalji and his conquests. Okay, let's start. As we studied in previous chapter, that after Balban's death, there was political instability in Delhi Sultanate and complete chaos in the court. And everyone wanted to get the chance from this situation, especially nobles. And they were engaged in conspiracy against each other. And one of these was the prominent noble Jalaluddin Khalji took the advantage of the situation and laid the foundation of Khalji dynasty. Okay, let's know about the Jalaluddin Khalji. Jalaluddin Khalji ascended the throne of Delhi in 1290 CE. He ruled only 6 years in Delhi Sultanate. He started his career as an officer of Mamluk dynasty and rose to an important position under the Sultan Kakbad, and thus he became a prominent noble and later became the Sultan of Delhi Sultanate. Jalaluddin, who was around 70 years old at the time of his accession, according to the historian, he was mild-mannered, humble and kind monarch to general public. He was not more interested to expansion and extended his empire, and he adopted a pacific policy. Pacific means cool and calm policy, and he forgave not only those who revolted against him, but also robbers and thugs. And due to this, his empire plagued by the internal conflict. And in this way, his mild nature was seen as unsuitable for the position of Sultan. And as the result, the other nobles began to conspiracy against him, and even his own nephew and son-in-law Alauddin Khalji took the advantage of this internal conflicts and weakness of Jalaluddin Khalji, and then conspired against him with the help of other nobles. He bribed the other powerful noble in gained his support, and in 1296 CE Alauddin killed the Sultan and declared himself as the next Sultan, and he also murdered and blinded the Jalaluddin's son and grandson. And in this way, Alauddin Khalji removed all obstacles from his path. And the next Sultan is Alauddin Khalji. I think you all are familiar to this word, Alauddin Khalji. Alauddin was just opposite to Jalaluddin Khalji. Alauddin was diplomatic, ruthless and ambitious ruler. And after ascended the throne, he adopted the policy of conquests and expansion, because just opposite to Jalaluddin, because he was very ambitious and wanted to conquer more and more territories, or we can say that he wanted to become a worldwide ruler. And the borders of Delhi Sultanate reached close to the South India during his reign. And he proved himself as a capable ruler. And several reforms were carried out by him. in the sector of administration, military, civil services, revenue and economic and market control. And so let's see the achievement of Alauddin. And firstly we see the conquest of Alauddin. Only Alauddin was the first ruler of Delhi Sultanate who extended his empire in both North and South India. Okay, now we talk about the North India territories. The first one is Gujarat. Alauddin conquered and annexed Gujarat in 1299 CE. And from here, he bought a slave was named Malik Kafur. He was bought in 1000 dinar. So, he was called Hazar Dinari. And he was so clever, cunning and expert to cheat others. And because of his qualities, Alauddin promoted him to the rank of general in army. And it is said that Malik Kafur was very close to Alauddin Khalji. And the next one, Rajasthan. After victory over Gujarat, he turned towards Rajasthan. He invaded Ranthambore in 1300 CE and defeated the Rajput rulers, and then invaded Chittor, the capital of Mewar. The Rajput rulers, the Rana Ratan Singh, fought very bravely, and at last point he didn't lose his courage, but lost the battle. Because Alauddin's force was very large and which had an excellent weapon and artillery and cavalry. And the women of royal family performed Johar. And later he captured Mandu, Ujjain, Malwa. In this way, he had established his control over North India. And next point, and after that he turned back to the Deccan. Deccan is referred to the territories of Western and Southern India. After the conquest of North India, he began his victory campaign for Deccans. And Alauddin Khalji was the first Muslim ruler of India who sent expedition to South India and also succeeded there. When he conquered Malwa, then automatically Deccan's path opened for him. And in the Deccan was bumpy, rough way and the rugged terrain, very long distance from Delhi. Therefore, earlier rulers were not interested to send their expedition to Deccan. But Alauddin Khalji was ambitious and wanted to conquer that area. And according to the historian, there were two purposes of Alauddin for attacking the kingdoms of South. The South was not plundered so far by the Muslim invaders, and the South kingdom had amassed wealth, and his primary aim was to capture the amassed wealth from Deccan, and the secondary aim was attainment of glory. And at that time there were four prosperous and strong states in South. In southwest of Vindhyas, the kingdom of Devgiri and Yadavs were the ruler of there. And southeast was the Kakyats kingdom of Telangana and Warangal, and Hoysalas of Dwarsamudra and Pandyas of Madurai. So, he sent his military commander Malik Kafur for the Deccan expedition. And Malik Kafur defeated the Yadavs of Devgiri, the Kakatiyas of Warangal, Hoysalas of Dwarsamudra, and Pandyas of Madurai. And Malik and he defeated them with the help of this huge and powerful army and excellent strategy and diplomacy. And Deccan's victory's credit goes to Malik. And after conquered great areas, Alauddin realized that it would be very difficult to control the territories of Deccans from Delhi. As I told you, he wanted amass wealth as much as possible from south, and he wanted to use this money to maintain his huge army, and hence he made Deccan territories as a vassal state and forced the rulers to accept the suzerainty of Delhi Sultanate and keep sending him annual tribute. And next point is the threats of Mongol invasions. The Mongol threatened the security of India from towards the northwest, and they invaded many times during Alauddin's period, and fierce as compared to previous one, because the Mongols wanted to take revenge from India for their defeat and disgrace. But Alauddin was able to put them down with remarkable efficiency and with the help of his huge standing army. And several measures and reforms were carried out to prevent further attacks, such as the new forts were built and repaired old ones, and capable and efficient military general were appointed in their forts for their security. Second one, he created a huge and powerful army and equipped them with excellent and modern artillery and weapons. And several reforms and measures were done for maintaining his army. And during the battle, those Mongol leaders were captured, were trampled under the feet of elephant, and those Mongols had settled in Delhi during the reign of Jalaluddin Khalji were ordered to massacre. And in this way, Alauddin Khalji suppressed the attacks of Mongol and forced them to flee.